Hi everyone, Amber here. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm sharing a mini album that I created as part of a mini album YouTube hop with a bunch of talented ladies. So it's a big group of talented crafters and we all created a mini album. So I will leave all of their links down below. So definitely be sure to hop around and see all of the beautiful albums that everyone else participating created. So for this one that I'm making here, I'm starting with an acetate base. I'm taking a piece of acetate that measures 5 by 10 inches, and I'm scoring that at 4 and 6 inches on the 10 inch side. And then I am just folding up on those score lines. So super easy so far. For the pages, I'm taking 6 pieces of paper that measure 4 3/4 inch by 7 3/4 inch. And I'm scoring on the long side at 3 3/4 and 4 inches. So this is going to create a 1/4 inch gusset on all 6 of our pages. And we are going to use those gussets to adhere our pages to the base of our album. So I did not have double-sided paper. So to fix that, as you can see, I just added paper to the inside of my pages. So I'm showing you on this album that I made previously that I stitched the pages to the spine of the base directly. This time I'm going to be using adhesive, but if you have a sewing machine, you can definitely take that route. It is a bit more time consuming because you do need to be very accurate when you are stitching, but that is an option. I love how it looks. I'm just going a different route today. So I'm using 1/4 inch double-sided tape. I'm adding that directly to the back of the gusset for all of my pages. You can use any adhesive that you'd like or that you have on hand. Just keep in mind that we are using acetate as a base, and sometimes adhesives don't like to stick to acetate very well. So keep that in mind and use a very sticky, strong one if you are going the adhesive route instead of the sewing one. So now that I have adhesive on all of the back gussets of my pages, I'm going to start adhering them to the spine. So I've opened up my mini album base and I'm just going to line up my page. I'm going to keep it centered and I'm going to use the score line on the base as a guide to keep it straight, and then I'm going to adhere it down. So you'll notice I struggled a bit with adding these pages in. I promise you, adding these pages in is not hard. I just have a filming setup where my project is farther away from me than I typically would have a project when crafting, so I couldn't really see well where I was adding everything, so I kept having to adjust the pages, but I promise you adding these is super easy. It's just the way my filming station is set up that I had some trouble seeing what I was doing. So you basically just want to use that first page that you adhered as a template to add all of your other ones in. And you can see that as you go along with this process, you have a pretty patterned of papers and stuff on the outside of your spine. I really like how that looks, so that's why I do like the stitching option, because when we use adhesive, we don't really want to be able to see the adhesive. You can see that it looks sticky and it's not really pretty. So to cover that, I'm going to take a piece of paper that measures 1 7/8 of an inch by 4 7/8 of an inch. And I'm just going to add that directly to the outside of the spine. So unfortunately, we are covering up all of those pretty papers and sneak peeks of the inside of the album, but we are going to embellish the spine like crazy, or at least I am. So in the end, we still have something really pretty to draw the eye in. So here's a quick little flip through. You can see you have a ton of pages to work with in this album. So moving on to some embellishing, I have some hand-painted beads, some paper beads, some tiny tassels, and some charms, And I'm taking just plain old regular white elastic, and I'm just going to thread a mixture of all of these pieces, all of these bits and pieces onto the elastic until I have enough so that it's as tall as my mini album. And then I am just going to add the first one because I am adding two of them. The first one will go and you will tie it around on the inside of the album on the third page. And then the second one will be tied on the fourth page. That way they are directly in the center of the spine because we are going to be adding some more embellishments to the other sides of the spine. So I have my first one tied in and now I'm just repeating that process again for the second one. I really love how all of the different textures of the tassels with the thread and then the charms and the beads and the paper beads, I just love how it all looks. It's very fun. It draws the eye in. It's the first thing you see when you look at the album, and I just think it looks super cute. So now that I have that one done, I'm going to add it to the inside of the fourth page. The first time I tied the elastic, it was really loose, and that just makes it droopy, and you don't want that. So I had to untie it, and then I just tied it really tight so that everything stays into place. So using the elastic also allows you to add more inserts or pages or memorabilia. You can just slip it right onto the elastic and you have more spaces in your album. So I'm just kind of making sure everything looks nice and is lined up. And now I'm going to move on to adding some rolled paper flowers. I get asked a lot how I make these. I use cut files from Paige Evans. I will leave a link to that down below in the description box as well. I just use my Cricut to cut them out and then I just roll them up. I know there are tutorials on how to do it without a cutting machine. You can YouTube that, you know, just DIY rolled paper flowers, and I'm sure a whole bunch of tutorials will pop up. So this is what it looks like with all of the rolled flowers and the charms added. And now I am going to do a quick little flip through. So this is the finished project. I added some embellishments to the cover and some trim to every other page inside to give it some extra texture. But that is how you make the super cute journal style mini album. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Be sure, like I said, to check out the description box for all the links to all the mini albums that everyone else created. And I will see you guys in my next video. Take care and happy crafting. Bye.